throttle for the month of May. IMS putting a plan in place in the event that race day is a washout. IMS President Doug Bowles says they aren't making any decisions just yet. CBS4 meteorologist Ethan Rosuck joins us. Ethan, you got to tell us, how are things looking Sunday?
I just crossing our fingers at this point here, Chelsea and Bob. That's basically the point here. You know, if you've been following along over the last several days, we've been talking about how, yes, there is rain in the forecast for the weekend, especially on race day on Sunday. And this isn't the first time we've had rain. If you've been around to races in the past, you know that. 2004, 20 years ago for race day, is the rainiest one on record, where we had 3.8 inches of rain. The warmest ever was 1937 with a high of 92. The coldest high temperature was 1992 with a high of only 58. And in 1947, the low temperature was a bone-chilling 37 degrees. It has been postponed 5 times, and it's been shortened several times, most recently in 2007, where only 166 laps were completed. In 1997, the race was postponed by 2 days, and this has happened on several occasions. I also want to mention that this is also the 20th anniversary of the race day tornadoes that occurred on May 30th, 2004. On that day, the race was completed, but it was postponed twice. 180 laps were completed, or 450 miles around the track. In that day, there were 23 tornadoes and 15 here in central Indiana, and the track was evacuated because of an F2 rated tornado in Marion County with peak winds between 117 and 157 miles per hour that occurred just 6 miles south of the track. And at the time, it was the second largest outbreak, where in total $13 million worth of damages occurred and 26 people were injured. Now, as Chris will explain later on in his forecast, yes, there is rain, but we're hoping we're going to see a window of opportunity, as we like to call it, to potentially have the race go on, maybe with a slight delay, but we'll fine tune that in the days ahead here. We'll have more details on the race day weather history coming up in a bit on CBS4Indy.com. Guys.
All right, Ethan, thank you very much.